Well, let's talk about the national efforts now more to combat HIV/AIDS in the country. I bring in now Director of Research of the Institute of Research, Nigerian Institution of Research, Dr. Oliver Ezechi. Thank you very much for joining us on the news at this time now. Perhaps we can begin with whether indeed there can be a cure for HIV/AIDS.
Yes, in medicine, there's no never. There's no always. There's a cure, but presently now, while we are waiting for that cure to come, we need to prevent people from getting new infections. We also need to treat people who are already HIV positive. If you've listened to what you heard, undetected means you cannot transmit. So if you treat people who are already positive, and to the level that the virus is supposed to undetected level, they can no longer transmit the infection, and the new infection cannot occur.
Okay, so the prevalence rate, so prevention is the key now, and of course, you know, dotting the T's and crossing the I's, so to speak. But prevalence in Nigeria now of this now has dropped from a 2.8 to a 1.4 now. Mm. However, Nigeria still remains number two in the world with the highest number of infections, so to speak. Why is that?
Because of our sheer population. We're 100 million people.
Far more than that.
So if 180 million people, what it means that even if 1%, when you calculate that total population, prevalence, that total population, that's our burden is second. But in terms of HIV prevalence, our HIV prevalence is much lower than countries in East and Southern Africa. So, but what it means that, what it's telling us that, what it means, Nigeria will have a larger number of people to treat. The resources we're going to use to treat those people are far larger than a country like Botswana that might have HIV in two digits. But the total population of the entire Botswana is less than 2 million.
But Nigeria is not the largest country in the world. Yeah. So what are the odds that we have against us as a nation in lowering these numbers drastically, particularly now mother-to-child transmissions that still ranks the highest in the world?
Yeah, in the last decade, we've done great. Remember, we started from 5.8. Now we are 1.4. We need to congratulate for ourselves. We have done well. But we are now in the next phase now. Now we brought the prevalence down. The total number of persons living with HIV have dropped from 3.5 million to 1.9 million. That is not easy to achieve. So what we need to do now is to ensure that new infections are not occurring. And people who are already positive are treated so that they cannot transmit that infection. If you continue the way we are going, the end for HIV is near.
So this year now, and we're inching closer and closer to the 2030 end game now for HIV, to tackle HIV, so to speak now. This year, it's all about
communities.
There's still the issue, the gap with the youth and the women. Let's talk about the youth, for example. Now, what do we need to do?
For example, at Nigerian Institute of Medical Research, in the last night survey, we realized although the prevalence have come down, the burden have come down, but there's a segment of the population, and that's the youth and young persons that are not being addressed. So what we are doing at Nigerian Institute of Medical Research now is to ensure that we use the youth to design a program. You know, like an adult, if I design a program for a youth, the youth, they're not likely to use that strategy. But what we are doing now is that we are now getting them to design a program that the youth wants. Secondly, again, we also now encourage self-testing. Young persons want to do their thing in closets. So the self-testing kits are available. Lagos State Health SACA have purchased the self-testing kits. So what it means that young persons don't need to come to the hospital to get tested. They can test in the confines of their home. At the Nigerian Institute of Medical Research, we also developed an app. A young person can download on a mobile phone, get the self-testing kit, test in comfort of your home, and we follow you through a dialogue. When the result comes out, if it's negative, we encourage you to continue.
Come forward.
If it's negative, we congratulate you and encourage you to continue doing what you are doing that made you negative. But we also link it up to a youth-friendly center where you can have tests for sexually transmitted infection, because those are the things that open the window for HIV. If you are positive, which is very good, which also in quote, for us, is positive, is good that because we identified that single person. And then we ask two questions. Do you want us to call you, or do you want us to refer you to a center? Once the person said, call me, we'll call you immediately.
All right. We'll see how it all goes. It sounds really, really good. We'll see how it all goes. We wish you all the best. Dr. Oliver Ezechi, thank you very much.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.